It was a dream come true. I'm traveling around in this well-known band, high heel and the sneakers. Life was a party. At least, that's how it looked on the outside. Yet on the inside, I was very much alone and empty. But I made an amazing discovery, and that changed the desires of my heart forever. I'm Lisa Larson. Join me for this women's event on Saturday, February the 22nd at Trinity Church from 9 to 11. Come and hear how my heart went from high heels to a higher cause.
So please take a minute to turn your chairs, get real comfortable, and please join me in welcoming Lisa and the Jensen Brothers.
Good. I'd like to take a minute and introduce the Johnson Brothers. Chris is over here on acoustic guitar, and he's also going to be doing a little bit of piano. Eric's over here on my right. He plays an acoustic bass, and he plays the upright bass as well. It's a beautiful instrument just to look at, even if he doesn't play it. Eric and I were in a band together called Tees.
Wait a minute. Didn't we name that band after your hair, Lisa?
That's the way it's gonna go.
Jesus has truly changed the desires of my heart and made me a new person. Although I did say goodbye to the band High Heel and the Sneakers, I refuse to give up my high heels. I mean, there are so many pros to high heels. They make you look taller. They make you look more slender. And I must say, when I wear mine to the grocery store, or
work or taking a shower. When I'm wearing my high heels, man. Scrumptious? I mean, I cannot wait to get my hands on a pair of these shoes. Are they size 7s? Yes. I thank you, Lord. These shoes today have been given to us by a lady named Becky, sitting right over here, if you're interested in trying on a pair. You know, I have always loved high heels. And from the time I was a little girl, and I played a dress up with my mom's high heels, I think I knew, even then, that I wanted to be a singer. I lived in a small town of 250 people, Dawson. Anybody here from Dawson today? They don't get cable down there. So. I lived on a my mom and dad and my two sisters. My dad was a carpenter and my mom was a stay-at-home mom. She raised us girls. My two sisters are here today, Kim and Kathy. My mom had always wanted to be a singer and she had aspirations of her own to do the big band thing. But she left that dream behind. A lot of people wonder how it is that you get into bands. And for me, I think it began with my dad. He was an encourager, and he was the first one that sat down with me and taught me how to harmonize to the song, You Are My Sunshine. Everybody knows that song. And my two sisters would sing the melody, and I would harmonize in a jump rope, because I made a good microphone. It was fun for me, but I think it was serious. I think that was the first seeds that were planted. I used to do shows at home in my bedroom. I would practice in the mirror for hours, singing to records and trying to duplicate the artist. I loved big hair, lots of makeup. And I remember seeing Cher for the first time on TV, and imitating her with the false eyelashes and the blue eyeshadow and the wig. And I actually have a picture of me sitting on top of our piano. Trying to pretend I was her. I know you can't believe that I like dressing up like Cher, but it's true. I would turn my bedroom into an auditorium and staple blankets to the beam of the ceiling to make a big stage. And so I'd have these programs, and I would invite my mom and dad, and it was produced by Lisa, hair and makeup by Lisa, and starring Lisa. Occasionally I gave my sisters a small role. So I guess it's no surprise that after I graduated from high school that I was ready to get out of my small town and move to the city to pursue my dreams of glamour, stardom, and music. I began as an art major in college. I worked in a retail clothing store. I did fashion illustrations for the Omaha World Herald. And I started singing in bands. And you know, when you're young, you can do all those things and not be stressed out. But during this busy time in my life, my mom was diagnosed with cancer. And in those last 6 months while she was really sick, I began to wonder about God and heaven and where she was going to go. And after she died, I began to question God and his purpose for life. And I wondered what would happen to me. And I wondered if I'd ever see my mom again in heaven. And I had a void inside, and I didn't know what it was. The craving to sing grew stronger. And an opportunity came up to sing with a well-known group called High Heel and the Sneakers. All the other jobs took a back seat to this band. This was the void that I was missing. So I thought. And temporarily, I was content with this choice. I was 3 years into High Heel and the Sneakers, and the band was doing very well financially. We had plenty of work. We had developed a regular following. We had high-profile gigs throughout the Midwest, and High Heel and the Sneakers was a household name in this region. We had recorded CDs. We had a video. Life was a party. And here is a brief glimpse of that time.
Anytime when the sun descends alone, I ran a long, long way from home to find a heart that's made of stone. I would try, I just need a little time to get your face right out of my mind, to see the I became more and more like those I was living with.
there was a God? Yeah, I did. I believe there was a God. Did I know him? No. Did I understand who God was? No. Deep down, I wanted to be religious. I wanted to be spiritual, and I wanted to know God. I know that's hard to believe looking at that video, but it's true. I did not know how to achieve this. I dreamed of having a husband and having kids someday, but I was in and out of many relationships, and all of them ultimately failing. Obviously, with my lifestyle, I was only going to attract a certain type of guy, but that wasn't the type of guy I wanted. And the type of guy I wanted, I didn't think I deserved. So with all the travel and the late nights and the competition for my time, relationships didn't last. Although I was not content, in my mind, the band came first. And I was not willing to give up my position in this band for anything or anyone. But I did begin searching for someone who had answers about God. One of my boyfriends along the way, thinking that he understood my need for spirituality, took me to a service at a little Nazarene church. And I was excited to go. It was a Sunday evening, which is kind of neat because I didn't do much in the mornings. But it was there that I heard for the first time that this emptiness that I felt inside could only be filled with Jesus. And then they explained that I could invite Jesus into my heart to be my Savior. And the pastor even said, there's someone out there that feels a tugging at their heart. And if that is you, you need to come forward and we'll pray for you. Well, I knew it was me they were talking about. But I was too shy to go forward. I knew what I heard was true, though. I didn't understand everything, but I knew that relationship with Jesus was exactly what I needed. So I filled out one of those cards in the back of the pew. Requesting that someone come and talk to me about this Jesus. And you know what? They came. Those Christians, I'm telling you. They show up. Especially if you invite them. They were very friendly, and during our conversation they asked me, Lisa, do you know for certain if you died today that you would go to heaven? And I said, well, I don't know. I hope so, but I don't know. I'd like to. They told me that eternal life is a free gift, and it's not earned or deserved. They read me Ephesians 2:8-9. For it is by grace you have been saved, through faith. This is not from yourselves. It is a gift from God, not by works, so that no one can boast. They explained to me that the Bible says that all man has sinned and cannot save himself. God wants everyone to go to heaven, and God is merciful, but God is just. And he's going to hold us accountable for our sins. Well, I knew I was a sinner. I knew I was not living right. I wanted to go to heaven, but I had all this sin and I didn't know what to do with it. And then they shared with me who Jesus was. He's God's son. And he died on the cross for our sins. And then miraculously came back from the dead. Jesus paid the price for all of us. And now he offers us the free gift of eternal life. Well, this was good news for me. I realized I could be forgiven of my sins. I had a way to release all this guilt and sin that I didn't know what to do with. I admitted that I had sin in my life, and I asked Jesus to forgive me of all my sins. Praise the Lord. Now, I'm going to tell you that with this group of people sitting in my little apartment telling me that I needed to repent of all my sins, I didn't list every sin that I had out in detail, or they would have been there for months. Nor was I even aware of all the sin that I had. Rather, I asked in faith for forgiveness of all my sins, to realize that God would help me deal with them each in His time, over time. They asked me if I wanted to receive the gift of eternal life, and I said yes. I was tired of trying to do it on my own. I knew my way wasn't working out. So I had to make a choice. And I decided to turn my life over to Jesus. And I accepted Jesus Christ as my personal Savior. I was hungry for knowing more about God. But I didn't even own a Bible. I didn't know what kind of Bible to buy.